So children, in the last video, I have given you some knowledge check. Yes or no? Yes. So now let's see what are those. Number A, you see, write the main nutrient present in the given food items. Okay, dal, bread, egg yolk and rice. So among these four, which one has the more nutrient? Yes, it is the egg yolk. Okay children? Yes. And now number B, you see, match the following. So we have to match this with this. Okay children? Yes. Number 1, simple carbohydrate. Number 2, complex carbohydrate. Number C, saturated fats. Number 4, unsaturated fats. And number 5, proteins. Okay? We have read this all. Yes or no children? Yes. Here you see this side. A, butter. B, egg white. C, glucose. D, starch. E, mustard oil. So we have to match this with this. Okay, simple carbohydrate, you see which one I have given? Yes, glucose. Yes or no children? Yes, we have read all these. Complex carbohydrate, starch, saturated fats, butter, unsaturated fats, mustard oil, proteins, egg white. Got it children? So, we have learned about nutrients, yes or no? So, what are the major 5 nutrients? Those are carbohydrates, fats, protein, vitamins and minerals. Yes or no children? Yes. So, out of these 5, we have learned about 3 in the last video. Yes or no? Yes. Those are carbohydrate, fats and protein. So, we have learned all that. Yes or no children? Yes. So, now we will learn about vitamins and minerals. Okay, so here we will learn about vitamins. Let's see what is vitamins. Okay children? Yes. Vitamins. Vitamins play a vital role in the growth and development of the human body. Vitamins are required only small amounts. This help us in developing immunity against many diseases. So children, vitamins play a vital role in the growth and development of our body. Okay children, our body needs vitamin, okay, in order to grow and development of our body. Okay, vitamins are required only in small amount. Okay, so we need very small amount of vitamin. Okay children, yes, this help us in developing immunity against many diseases. So vitamins act as a immunity, okay, against diseases. Means vitamins act as a shield, okay, as a cover against many diseases. Okay children, yes. So if we eat right amount of vitamins, we will be free from diseases. Got it children? Yes. There are different types of vitamins, namely vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K and vitamin B complex. Okay, so these are the vitamins. Okay children, there are different types of vitamins. So these are the name. Vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K and vitamin B complex. Got it children? Yes. Again, now we will see. Vitamin B complex is actually a group of vitamins. So again here, vitamin B complex is a group of vitamins. So what are the vitamins present in this vitamin B? We will see. Okay children, so those are vitamin B1, vitamin B2, vitamin B3, vitamin B5, vitamin B6, vitamin B7, vitamin B9 and vitamin B12. That means these vitamins are vitamin B complex. Got it children? Yes. Depending on their solubility in water, vitamins are of 2 types, fat soluble and water soluble. Okay. So depending on the solubility in water, vitamins are again of what? Yes. Again of 2 types. Got it children? What are those? Those are fat soluble vitamins and water soluble vitamins. Got it children? Now we will see what is fat soluble vitamins. Vitamins A, D, E and K are fat soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins are stored in the fat tissue of the body and are used when needed. So children, these vitamins, these four vitamins are stored in our body fats. Okay children, these are stored in our body fats and these are used when our body need them. Got it children? Yes, these are stored in a body fats and used when needed. Okay children, now we will see water soluble vitamins. Vitamin B complex and vitamin C are water soluble vitamins. Since these vitamins are not stored in the body, these have to be supplied regularly through food. So what happened? These water soluble vitamins are not present in our body, okay? Like fat soluble vitamins, these are present in our body fats. Yes or no children? Yes, but these water soluble vitamins are not present in our body, okay? So we have to take them regularly through food. Okay children? Yes. Now you see this one. Remember, in addition to dietary sources, it is found that when sunlight falls on the skin, certain reactions take place producing vitamin D. It is therefore termed as the sunshine vitamin. So whenever we stand in the sun or whenever the sunlight falls in our skin, what happens? Yes, vitamin D produced. Okay children, we get vitamin D. So it is therefore this sunshine vitamin, this sunlight we get is the sunshine vitamin. Okay children, now children we will see what this diagram about. Okay, different vitamins, their functions in the body and their sources. So we will see about vitamins and their functions in our body and from which food we get such particular vitamins. Got it children? First one we will see vitamin A. So functions is needed for proper visions and improves immunity. So if we eat vitamin A, what happen? Our eyesight will be good. We can be able to see properly. Got it children? And it improves immunity. So here immunity means what children? Immunity means resistant. Okay, so it improves our immunity. That means whenever the disease from outside try to attack our body, this immunity, this vitamins, it improves the immunity. So this helps in resistance. Okay children, so that we won't get sick quickly. Okay, yes. So these are the foods: carrots, oranges, ripe yellow fruits, soy milk, green leafy vegetables. So these are the foods that we get vitamin A. Got it children? So if we want our eyes to be powerful, want to see clearly, and if we don't want to get sick easily, we have to eat these foods. Okay children? Now vitamin B complex: B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, B9 and B12 helps in metabolism. So children, now tell me what is metabolism. Okay, metabolism is a process. Okay, it's a process where foods are converted into energy. Okay children, so this vitamin B helps in such converting such process. Okay children, whenever we eat food or drink, okay, whenever we eat food or any drink we take, what happened? This food or drink, it converts into energy. Yes or no children? Yes. So this vitamins help in such metabolism, such process. Okay children, so now you see what are the food: whole grains, beans, soybean, curd, liver, meat and fish. Okay children, and now vitamin C: maintains healthy bone and teeth, prevents cell damage, supports immunity, citrus. So what happened children? This, if we eat vitamin C, if we take vitamin C, what happened? Our teeth and our bone will be healthy. Okay children, and it prevents cell damage also, supports immunity. So immunity, you have seen here, what is immunity? Yes, it resists against diseases. Yes or no? So this vitamin C will support this immunity to resist against diseases. Got it children? And it prevents cell damage also. Okay, so what are the foods? Citrus fruits: orange, lemon, broccoli, spinach and tomato. Now vitamin D: maintains strong bones and teeth, aids in calcium absorption. Okay, so our bones and teeth will be strong. Okay, children, and aids in calcium means our body needs calcium, yes or no? So this vitamin D helps in absorbing this calcium. Okay, children, yes. So what are the food? Cod liver oil, eggs, and mushroom. Okay, vitamin E needed for absorption of vitamin A, protect body tissue from damage. Okay, so we need vitamin A, yes or no? Yes. So in order to take vitamin A, our this vitamin E is must. Okay, children, yes. And protect body tissue from damage. So here body tissue means our muscles, our nerves, those are the body tissues. Okay, so what happens sometimes our nerves gets failed, yes or no, and got paralyzed, yes or no, and our muscles also get weak sometimes, yes or no, children? Yes. So this vitamin E is needed for keeping our muscles and nervous system strong. Okay, children, and let's see what are the food. Mango, guava, sunflower seeds, spinach, nuts, and almonds. Now last one, vitamin K helps to build strong bones, helps in blood clotting problems. So it helps in our bone to be strong, okay, children, and in blood clotting problems. So sometimes what happens, if we get cuts, our body used to flow continuously and it don't stop, yes or no, children? If blood clot means that after coming out from the bone, what happened? It's become semi-liquid or it's become solid, yes or no, children? Yes. So blood clot means that solid, okay, the blood that becomes solid is a blood clot. Okay, children, yes. So if the blood did not clot, if the blood did not become solid, what happened? It keeps on flowing. Okay, children, yes. So the blood clot is needed, okay, children, so that the blood will not come out again. Okay, children, yes. So this vitamin K help in such blood clotting problems. Got it? And let's see now what are the food. Green leafy vegetables, cabbage, egg yolk, and liver. You understood, children? Okay. Then we have already learned about carbohydrates, fats, protein, vitamin, yes or no? And now what is left? Minerals. Okay, let's see what is minerals. Minerals are needed for the formations of bones, teeth, and red blood cells. So children, why do we need minerals? We need minerals for our bones, teeth, and red blood cells to function properly, to form properly. Okay, minerals help in proper functionings of muscles and in maintaining normal heartbeat. Okay, so minerals help in what, children? Yes, they help in functionings of our muscles and heartbeat. Okay, if we have the right amount of minerals in our body, what happens? Our muscles and our heartbeat will function properly. Okay, depending on the requirement in the body, minerals are divided into two groups, major minerals and trace minerals. So again, minerals are of two types. What are those? Those are major minerals and trace minerals. They are divided in what? Yes, they are divided according to the requirement by our body. Okay, children, now let's see major minerals. These minerals are required in large quantities by the body. For example, calcium, magnesium, potassium, and sodium. So children, major minerals are needed in large quantity, okay, in big quantity, big amount by our body. Okay, and let's see what are the example, what are the minerals, what are the major minerals. Okay, those are calcium, magnesium, potassium, and sodium. Okay, and now let's see what is trace and minerals. Trace minerals, these minerals are required in lesser quantities by the body. For example, iron, zinc, copper, and iodine. So children, trace minerals are needed in less quantities by our body. Okay, unlike major minerals, they are needed in small quantity. Okay, so let's see what are the trace minerals. Those are iron, zinc, copper, and iodine. Okay, so milk product, green leafy vegetables, fish, iodine, salt, fruits, seeds, and pulses are a few source of minerals. So what are the food that we get minerals? Those are milk products, all the milk products like paneer, curd, okay, green leafy vegetables, okay, fish, iodized salt, fruits, seeds and pulses. Okay, those are the food that we get minerals. Okay, children? Yes. So here you see science in action. It is not always possible to meet body requirement of vitamins through diet only. So children, if just by eating our body, sometime what happened, do not get vitamins as it needed. Okay children, therefore what happened, artificial vitamins have been synthesized. So for that, artificial vitamins are synthesized, are made. Okay children, these are called vitamin supplements. So those artificial vitamins are called what? They are called vitamin supplement. Okay children, vitamin C, the first artificial vitamin was synthesized in 1935. So vitamin C was the first artificial vitamin and it was made in the year 1935. Okay, since then a whole range of vitamins are synthesized artificially. So after coming out of this vitamin C, many more vitamins are came up. Okay children, so children, here I have put some question. Let's see what are those. First one, you see, how will you test for protein in a given food sample? And second one, define two groups of minerals with an example from each group. Okay children, so you try to find it out. So let's stop here today. Let's meet in the next video.